أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. Dear brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Those who are intended to go to Hajj this year, we call them pilgrims. And those who already done Hajj before, and even those who couldn't do Hajj, and even up to now they are looking forward to do Hajj, but they couldn't so far. This year is inshallah for everyone. I'm just giving you the introduction of the series, why we want to discuss this together. All of us, the whole Muslim Ummah, we want to do something this year special. We want everyone to do Hajj this year. All millions and billions of Muslims, they should do Hajj this year. Is it possible? Yes. Because everyone will do Hajj with his heart. Some people will demonstrate this. They will go by their body, but they will accompany with them their hearts. Some others, they can't go to Mecca, but they will do Hajj with their hearts. I'm telling you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept the deeds according the hearts, not the body. The body just will listen to the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, how to pray, how to do Hajj. But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that لَيْسَ لِلْمَرْءِ مِنْ صَلَاتِهِ إِلَّا مَا عَقِلَ مِنْهَا. No one will be rewarded out of his salah, his prayers, except what he was full-minded, his heart was present there. Then he will get the rewards of salah, especially the rewards. When you pray, the fard of prayers will be dropped, but the rewards depends on your heart, your khushu', your mind. Was it full minded of the salah, understanding the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the love you offer salah with the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Same Hajj. If you go to demonstrate, you go to offer Hajj with your body, the Hajj fard will be dropped, but the rewards, Al-Hajj Al-Mabroor, there is a condition, Al-Hajj Al-Mabroor, this is the one you will be rewarded for this Hajj with Jannah. You will guarantee Jannah. من حج فلم يفث ولم يفسخ رجع كيوم ولادته أمه. The one who will offer Hajj with the condition of the sincere Hajj, perfect Hajj, he is the one, he will be forgiven. He is the one who will be as a newborn, and he will guarantee Hajj. This is with the heart. But for the rewards, yes, maybe you will be at home. You couldn't go to Mecca, yet you will get the full reward of Hajj. Is it possible? Yes, Allah promised you. If you show Allah your sincerity, that you are really keen to do it, and you do your best, even if you couldn't. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he went to the battle of Tabuk, thousands of miles away from Medina. When he finished and he came back, he said to his Sahaba, he said that there are some people in Medina, we haven't climbed any mountain, we haven't crossed any valley, any single step we did, they share with us the rewards. حبسهم العذر. They couldn't come with us because they have been exempt. They have a genuine excuse. Some of them, they are disabled. They couldn't come with us. Some of them, they are able to come, but they haven't got the means. As the Quran said, they came to the Prophet ﷺ before he left to the battle of Tabuk. Find a camel for us, we want to come with you. قلت لا أجد ما أحملكم عليه. Oh Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you respond to them, I don't have enough camels for you. تولوا وأعينهم تفيض من الدمع حزنا ألا يجدوا ما ينفقون. They left the Masjid Nabawi because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I don't have enough camels for you. They left and their eyes overflows with the tears. Why? Because they are grieving. They couldn't have the means to go with the Prophet ﷺ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala exempt them. Allah reward them the full rewards of jihad. So yourself, if you couldn't go to Hajj with a genuine reason, but your heart is really grieving, your heart looking forward with the love to go to Mecca, to please Allah, to go to Arafah, I'm giving you the glad tidings that Allah will give you the full rewards as if you are there. How many people at their homes and they will get the reward of the full Hajj. On the other hand, you'll find many who are on Arafah and they missed the reward of Hajj because their hearts was not there. The heart is not there. So now this session for everyone. We want all Muslims this year to do Hajj with their hearts. If they go there, if not, they will do Hajj with their hearts. Many people, they said that I did many Hajj and he feel proud. We tell him, listen, you know Hajj for what? Hajj to wash the noob, the sins. Some people, they are sinked in the major sins and they are really proud. I'm going to offer Hajj, then Allah will forgive me. Number one, you can't be smart with Allah. You are not sure that you'll get the perfect Hajj or not, is going to be accepted and Allah will forgive you or not. Secondly, it's not something really to be proud of, to say I'm washing myself. Some people, they couldn't offer Hajj, but they are much better than you. Why? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in the hadith, اتَّقِ الْمَحَارِمْ تَكُنْ أَعْبَدِ النَّاسِ. If you avoid the sins, the major sins, you will be the best obedient. Even if you couldn't offer Hajj, if you couldn't go to Mecca, the heart, ibadat, worship according the heart. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Man qala la ilaha illallah mukhlisan biha qalbu," usually people said, "Whoever said la ilaha illallah, he guarantee Jannah." What is the condition? Mukhlisan biha qalbu. So the heart sincerely submit to the word La ilaha illallah. You can say it, but with the ikhlas of the heart. If the heart did tasdeeq and full of iman of La ilaha illallah, he wouldn't commit any sin. He wouldn't miss any fard. Why? Because when he heard the adhan, he said, La ilaha illallah. The most beloved to me is Allah. I have to leave everything and go to salah. For any fard, he will never miss it. Why? Because La ilaha illallah in the heart, مُخْلِصًا بِهَا قَلْبُهُ. So the heart is full of iman of La ilaha illallah. Haram, whenever his eyes, his mind think about haram, he will say La ilaha illallah. That's why Yusuf alayhi salam, when he was at the moment of the وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ for the sin, he said مَعَاذَ اللَّهِ أعوذ بالله. That means Allah in his heart, he couldn't go for the sin. This is the way. It's not to perform many Hajj. It's not to fast many nafil days. It's not to pray lots, not to many khatma of Quran. Where is your heart? That's why we want everyone to focus. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, if you say subhanallah wa bihamdi 100 times, all your sins will be forgiven. Do you think because we said subhanallah wa bihamdi 100 times in few minutes? No. You need to do it with your heart. Subhanallah wa bihamdi. if you do it with your heart, then the heart will be full of the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will never miss any fard. He will never fall in any sin. Inshallah Azza wa Jal, we will focus inshallah in this series how to perform this Hajj with the heart. Everyone will share this Hajj. But inshallah, for those brothers and sisters who are going to go to Hajj this year, I'm going to conclude the process of Umrah in one session quickly. So the brothers and sisters, they will quickly understand what I should do. But we want to focus after that in few series, few episodes, how to get the best out of our Hajj and Umrah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى اللهم وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن اهتدى بهديه واستنى بسنته واقتفى أثره إلى يوم الدين. Dear brothers and sisters, today I'm going to focus on Umrah. For those who already Allah blessed them and already booked for the Hajj and all their materialistic preparation been done, they got the visa, they got everything. So before I started our episodes, just to, as we mentioned last time, that we want to do heart Hajj, and we let every Muslim to share with us. Everyone should do Hajj this year with their hearts. But for you especially, this session for you, those who are going to Mecca inshallah, we're going to conclude how to perform Umrah. Just to tell you, body wise is very simple. I will summarize this for you, then we will go for the meanings, the wisdom, what I should get spiritual preparation for the Umrah and Hajj inshallah. Now, what's Umrah? Umrah is very simple. We need to do four actions: Ihram, Tawaf, Sa'i, then Halq or Taqsir. Ihram, I'm sure you have listened to many Hajj Ta'aleem and but conclusion, quick summarize, this is the Umrah process is what? Ihram. Ihram come from the word is haram, that there is something will be forbidden. Once I come to the miqat, I need to put on the ihram. If I'm a brother, I put on the ihram two pieces, one at the top, one in the bottom. That's it. Khalas, this is the ihram. But the status of ihram will not start until I said labbayk allahumma umrah, because I'm going to start with umrah first. Then I will do Hajj after that. I'm going to focus here for Hajj Tamattu'. I'm not here for fiqh. No. Hajj Tamattu', I'm going to do Umrah. Then I will take off my ihram. Then I will do Hajj afterward. Umrah, put on the ihram. Sister, wear whatever you like. Then just leave the face and the hand and without cover. Then you said لبيك اللهم عمره, and you start تلبية لبيك اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة لك والمنك لا شريك لك. From now on, now many forbidden actions, I am sure you know them, is going to be prohibited, forbidden until you finish your عمره. Again summarizing this, you don't put any perfume, you no hunting anymore, and you can't really cut any for Mecca, for you or anybody else. Again, you can't really cut any plants. You can't really cut your nails, or you shave your head, or this is the actions, you know it. You can't cover your head. You can't. This is only the pieces of ihram. Then when you come to Mecca, you start tawaf. Summarize tawaf. You start from Hajj al-Aswad corner. Bismillah, Allahu Akbar. And you start, proceed for 7 rounds. 7 rounds. You do dhikr, dua, istighfar, Quran, dhikr. After you finish 7 rounds, if the Salat al-Fard started, you stop and pray behind the Imam. You finish, carry on. You missed your wudu, you go and do wudu and come back and carry on. If you finish 3, go to the 4th round. If you finish 5, go to the 6th round. After you finish 7 rounds tawaf, you go behind Maqam Ibrahim, pray 2 rak'ah. The 1st rak'ah, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, and Qul Ya Ayyuhal Kafirun. 2nd rak'ah, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, Qul Huwa Allahu Ahad. Then you go to Zamzam. You drink Zamzam, drink until you fill your tummy. Tatadalla, you find your ribs is coming out like this. And you make dua, Zamzam, for whatever you want for. Zamzam is blessed water. As you did shower and you clean your body, you need to clean your heart. You need to clean inside. This is Zamzam. You ask Allah the forgiveness. You ask Allah to increase you in knowledge, increase your iman, yaqeen, all this. Then you, after Zamzam, you go to Safa. And you start to do sa'i. Yes, at the Safa, you face the Kaaba and make dua. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah, lahu mulku wa lahu hamdu yuhyi wa yumiitu wa ala kulli shay'in qadir. La ilaha illallah wahdah, anjaza wa'dah wa nasara 'abdah wa hazama al-ahzaba wahdah. Then you make dua. Then you repeat this dhikr again, then dua. You repeat the dhikr again and dua. Then you proceed, go to Marwa. Between the two, the green light, you do a bit of jogging like this. Then after the green light, you walk normal until Marwa. Then you face Kaaba, make dua again. Come to Safa. Safa to Marwa, 1 count. Marwa to Safa, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th. So you start Sa'i at Safa and you finish at Marwa. Once you finish at Marwa, no more dua. You go and shave your head. Normally in Umrah, any Umrah we shave our head. But for this Umrah, because we're going to do Hajj, you can trim your hair. For the sister, just you cut one as your the tip of your any finger, one any like this, 1 centimeter. You cut your hair, but from the whole hair, the sister hold the whole hair and cut 1 centimeter. Or if you have 2 plaits, just 1 centimeter from him, 1 centimeter from here. The brothers, just trim your hair. This is khalas. Now you are normal. You finish your umrah. Take your off your ihram and you are normal. And ask Allah to accept your umrah. And in your umrah, you make dua. As in Ramadan, we said, Allahumma balighna Ramadan. We said, Allahumma balighna al-hajj. Allahumma balighna al-hajj. You are now in Mecca. Said, Ya Rab, Allahumma balighni Arafah. Allahumma balighni Arafah. Ya Rab, please, I don't want to miss Arafah day. In your umrah, remember this. And remember that this is Mecca. This Hajj, as we said last time, we want this Hajj to be different Hajj. We want this Hajj to be accepted Hajj. You know, if Allah accepted you this year, you will be saved all your life. You will be protected all your life. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has accepted your Umrah and Hajj this year, you will be a blessed man. If Allah released you from Jahannam, free you from Jahannam this year, you will be blessed, guided, obedient, very good Muslim up to the Day of Judgment, up to the last moment, you will die as Muslim. You'll see some people after they do Hajj, they come, they are different people. They never miss any Salah. Allah blessed them, Allah guided them. So once Allah accepted you this year, you will be blessed up to your death. And it happened to many of the Sahaba. They were already given the glad tidings. They were guaranteed Jannah. Al-Ashar al-Mubashirin al-Jannah. And other Sahaba who already, the Prophet ﷺ said, you are already guaranteed Jannah. Badr, 313 people. Rasulullah ﷺ said, all of you, now you have been forgiven. You guarantee Jannah. You can do whatever you like. Do you think people of Badr, after Badr battle, they said, oh, we've been forgiven, we guarantee Jannah? do whatever you like, corrupt, never. Once Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them the glad tidings that they guarantee Jannah, they will be blessed and guided up to the death. So if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted you this year, if Allah accepted your Hajj this year, you will be guided, you will be blessed. You will be a perfect mu'min until your death moment. You will die as Muslim. وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ So this is the blessings, this is the virtue of doing Umrah this year in a different way. Now I'm asking you, this is the time to have a full cleansing. This is the time of you can tell that this is the major cleansing process. Hajj trip. Since you leave your home, your walking is cleaning, washing your sins. Ghusl for ihram, washing your sins. Going for talbiyah, washing your sins. Enter Mecca and go to the Kaaba, washing your sins. Tawaf, washing yourself. Salah behind Maqam Ibrahim, washing yourself. Zamzam, washing your sins. You go to Safa wa Marwa, washing your sins. Halq, each hair you shave or trim, taking away sins. Each one. So all this washing, go to Mina, go to Arafah, Muzdalifah, Tawaf al-Ifadah, Rami al-Jimar, even each stone you throw, this is taking away one major sin. So this is the major cleansing process in your life. To come back, Allahu Akbar, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَوْ أَنَّ نَهْرًا بِبَابِ أَحَدِكُمْ يَغْتَسِلُ فِيهِ كُلَّ يَوْمْ خَمْسْ مَرَّاتِ أَيُبْقِي ذَلِكَ مِنْ دَرَنِهِ شَيْءٍ If you have a river in front of your doorstep, every day, five times, you come out from your house, have a shower, come back, five times. Do you think anyone would have any dirt on his body? Sahaba said, never, Ya Rasulullah, five showers every day. He said the same five prayers. Every time you pray, washing your sins. So you'll be clean. Now the much major cleansing process is Hajj. You go there, you clean everything, you come back perfect, pure. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that kayaw waladathu ummu, same as if you just been born now. So your record is clean. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant all of us brothers and sisters accepted and perfect Hajj and Umrah. وصلى اللهم وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم والحمد لله رب العالمين والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته